Hey, it's Lauren. Welcome back to my craft room. Thanks for joining me for this video. I am sharing this adorable yappy happy mail stamp set from Huffy Doodle and its die. I've stamped out a bunch of the envelopes, a package, a heart, this cute paper airplane that the die cuts a little slot inside of so you can put another image in, like that heart. It also cuts the slot of the post boxes so you can have a letter going inside of the mailbox. How adorable is that? I also colored and die cut quite a lot of poodles because I'm going to be showing how you can create three different cards, some different ideas from this stamp set. So I did the long hard work of coloring and cutting already. And we're going to start with our first card, which will be a slimline. I am using the Sweet Scalloped Slimline dies, also from Huffy Doodle. And I've cut the largest die out of some cherry red paper, the middle die out of some pale pink, and the smaller out of some kind of craft brown color. I also die cut the red heart and the word moi. Is that how you would pronounce that? I feel like you need the little like kissy sound with it, like moi. Sentiment from the die set as well. And that was out of white and black because I'm going to create a bit of a shadow look when I glue everything together. I wanted to try to use as many of the stamps from this set on all three of my cards. So I took the three solid stamps, it's two hearts and a paw print, and I'm going to stamp just along the edges of my pink paper because only a little bit will show behind that craft paper. I'm using Distress Oxide and Fired Brick because I thought it would look really nice on the pink paper. So together it kind of matches a little bit more of that cherry color. And I'm just going to stamp all the way around my pink paper, like I said, just along the edges. And to add a little bit of shine and bling, I'm going to use my Ink on 3 liquid pixie dust. And I grabbed a paintbrush from my stash, but it looks like it had a tiny bit of black ink still on my brush. So my shimmer looks a little silvery, but that's okay. Once it dries, it actually dries pretty clear. And as I said before, I die cut two of those sentiment words in white and black, and I'm going to layer the black a little off-centered from the white to create a shadow look for my large sentiment die cut. Once those are glued together, I'm going to start with assembling my card. We're going to start with that cherry red piece and glue on my pink layer. As you can see, that shimmer dried really nicely and it wasn't as gray looking as I was worried it would look. I glued that right to the center. Those two scallop pieces look so pretty together. Well, three, now that we're going to include the craft brown colored cardstock to the center of that. And then I'm going to layer on my sentiment as well as that red heart and then grab my stamped and colored images to figure out which poodle I'm going to do. I decide to go on this leaping brown poodle. I also brought out the card with the heart stamped and colored on it as well as the heart inside of my paper plane. I wanted to also stamp the sending love stamps from the stamp set to kind of give more of a sentiment onto the front of my card to make it a very nice Valentine's Day card. So I'm kind of deciding where everything is going to lay, and I'm pretty happy with that sending love in the top left hand corner. So I'm going to grab my Misty since I decided to do this after gluing everything together, and I'm just going to do my best to get it straight and in that top left corner, and my Misty will be really helpful with that in case I need to stamp twice. I will be embossing the sentiment, so I'm going to grab my VersaMark as well as my anti-static powder tool and just make sure I don't get a lot of ink and embossing powder where I don't want it to go. So I stamp once and it looked really good, so I'll go ahead and pull it off my Misty and I'm going to grab my white embossing powder. I'm just going to carefully cover that area and then I will warm up my heat gun while I clean up my powder mess and then use my heat gun to melt that embossing powder down until it's a nice shiny white sentiment. And then I have a little Swiffer cloth that I use just to wipe up that extra anti-static powder. To adhere everything down, I'm going to pop up my heart in the paper plane as well as my poodle, while my sentiment and my heart are going to be glued directly down with wet glue. So I'm just sharing some minimal gluing, but I'm just following that same layout that I had already showed you earlier when I was deciding on adding more to my sentiment. But I wanted to let you know that I did glue down the die cut word and the heart directly to my card, while my paper plane and my little poodle and his little card are popped up, just to give the card some dimension. And once I'm done adding all of my details of my images, I'm going to add it to a slimline card base. I just use some white cardstock. It is cut and scored to be 8.5 by 3.5 when it's folded. And I glued that directly down with just some wet glue. And I wanted to add a little bit of detail, so I'm going to grab my Pops of Color, which is this really pretty soft pink in a pearl liquid embellishment, and I just added some little dots onto my card, and I'm tapping underneath to dome them out so they're not so Hershey Kiss looking. And that will finish off my first slimline card. Here's a close-up of the cute card, and we will move on to card number 2. For my second card, I have a piece of mixed media paper already die cut with my Imperial Stitched Rectangle dies, and I'm going to do a little bit of distressing with some Distress Oxides. I'm starting in the center with Worn Lipstick, and then I will go around the edges of this paper with Festive Berries. I'm not creating a perfect seamless blend. It's going to look a little splotchy, I guess you could say, when I'm done. I'm just laying down enough color to that way I could do some additional stenciling and die cutting on top, and it's not going to be noticeable that there isn't a seamless blend. So I'm going to be grabbing my confetti heart stencil, and I place it on top of my background using my Make Art Staycation and station, and I'm going to be grabbing a paper towel and spritzing it with water and kind of stamping through the stencil. Now, looking back, I think I should have grabbed one of my domed foam blenders and squirted that with water and tried this technique, because it didn't really come through all the way. I tried spraying and then rubbing with my paper towel, but that made some pretty big blotches in some of the hearts. So it's kind of hard to tell that I was, as you can see here, trying to make little hearts in the background. Some of them did turn out okay, but for the most part, I think I need to think of a new way on how to try this technique. I decided to die cut it with my Stitched Hearts background die to add a little bit more of that texture and those hearts in the background that I was trying to achieve with my stencil. Now I went ahead and picked out the post box, this little brown package, a few letters, and a couple poodles playing around and mailing out their Valentines, and that will be what decorates my card. Everything here is popped up except for a couple of the letters, so I'm adding dimension to the post box with that little letter sticking out, the little package that my little poodle's going to be using to put the letter inside, as well as my poodle's putting the little paw print on his card. The letter on the mailbox, as well as behind the poodle, I used some wet glue to glue those down. Now for my sentiment, I decided to grab my curved banner die, and I'm using the Sending Happy Mail stamps. These are all individual stamps from the stamp set, and I'm going to see if it will fit onto this banner die, and it does, and I'm happy. So I went ahead and die cut it out of some white cardstock. And then using my clear block and the die, I'm going to try and bend my sentiment to fit so it creates a nice curve that will fit nicely inside of my die cut. So I left this part in even though it takes a little time, because I wanted to show you that if you have the patience, you can definitely do this with your stamps too. That's the nice thing about these clear photopolymer stamps is they're easy to maneuver and you can bend them to fit inside of curved sentiment. So while this die set, or this die does have a stamp set that has sentiments that are perfectly curved to already fit inside, you can still create your own sentiment for this banner die. Once I finally have it curved that it will look nice on my die cut, I'm going to grab my VersaFine and Onyx Black. I really like using VersaFine inks for stamping that is not in a Misty because it is such a great pigment ink and it stamps really nicely the first time and you don't need to worry about having to stamp twice. As you can see there, it's a great stamped sentiment. Now, while VersaFine is a fast drying pigment ink, I'm still gonna blast it a little bit with my embossing heat gun because there are some score lines on this banner die cut and I didn't wanna risk smearing and being sad that I have to do it again. So that's just a way to make sure the ink won't smear as I'm messing around with the paper. To add it to my card, I'm grabbing some scrapbook.com foam strips and I'm just placing it and curving it behind my banner. And then I will use wet glue on the folded back parts of my banner. And then I'm going to adhere this to the top center of my card, just above my cute little poodle mail post scene. And with that, I can start finishing up putting my card together. I found some navy cardstock in my stash, and I also die cut it with that same stitched heart background die, so there would be a seamless transition in the heart details between my distressed background and my navy blue paper. I am currently waiting for a refill of my card bases, so I'm going to leave this as a card front for now, and I will glue my base onto my 110-pound Nina cardstock once it gets here. I am going to add some of these really cute white clay hearts. These are from Buttons Galore and More. They're sprinklets, sweetheart sprinklets set. They come in three different colors, but I just wanted to use the white ones on this card. Here's a close-up of this cute little poodle sending a letter for card two. For card number three, I wanted to create a cute little scene, so I'm going to be grabbing out a bunch of my Huffy Doodle die sets. I cut some clouds from the Big Stitch Clouds dies out of some white cardstock, some trees from the Forest Builder dies out of some green and craft cardstock. I have Grassy Lass border dies to create my little grassy area for my little pups to play around in, and then my background was using the Imperial Stitched Rectangle dies out of some blue cardstock. So I have a scene kind of laid out, like penciled in, where I think I want everything to go, but I wanted to add this Oodles and Poodles of Love, which was my intention to use these two stamps together in the beginning. So I needed some room in my sky to add them. So I'm going to move my clouds around until I have some space to put that Oodles and Poodles. And then I decided to fill up a little bit of my sky with a die cut word love instead of stamping it on. So once I'm pretty happy with where I think my scene is going to fit nicely on the card, I'm going to grab my Misty and I'm going to center that Oodles and Poodles of stamp set to the top center of my blue sky cardstock piece. I'm going to stamp it in my VersaFine in Onyx Black just to add some contrast since it is a very light colored sky and I wanted to make sure my sentiment stood out nicely. So there I have my Oodles and Poodles of, and now I can start arranging my scene. So I'm going to share how I put together one of my trees with the cloud behind it. I added some glue to the whole tree trunk instead of just what would go onto my tree, but that's okay. I'll add more glue, and then I realized that I didn't place down my grass to know where I wanted my tree to go, nor did I place my cloud. So I kind of struggled a little putting together this scene. So then I was like, okay, well, I'll put the cloud down, and then I glued my tree. But then I didn't have any glue on my cloud, so I pulled it up, added glue, and now I can lay it down. So I repeated this process, but a little more efficiently on the right with my smaller tree. And then I'm going to use my foam strips to pop up the grass to the bottom portion of my background. Because the trees are smaller in respect to the dogs, I wanted to make sure the trees were behind the grass so they looked further away, just for perspective. And then I will pop up all of my poodles where they don't touch the grass, so where they're going to touch the background. And then I'll use wet glue to anywhere where the poodles touch the grass, so that way they are nice and secure. So there I have my cute little scene. I'm going to go ahead and die cut the word love. I'm using that cherry red cardstock from earlier, as well as white. And I'm going to kind of repeat that same process of creating a shadow behind my sentiment. So the red will be on top and the white will be slightly off-centered. And I will repeat that for all four of the letters. I'm going to use my grid mat to help me line up my love sentiment and some memo tape to pick that up, and then use my wet glue with a fine tip to add glue behind the love. And then I again will use my grid mat to help me center love underneath that sentiment. And that will finish off this card. I will add a craft kind of brown colored background, but again, I'm just creating a card front right now since I need more card bases. So this is just glued directly down to that craft cardstock, which is A2 in size. And here is a final look at this last card. I wanted to keep it simple and not be overly gushy or super shiny. So here is a look at all three cards. We have our sending love slimline, our poodles postbox, and our oodles and poodles of love cards. I think they turned out really cute, and I hope they give you lots of inspiration as well. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you'll click like, and if you're new here, I hope you'll subscribe and come back. As always, you can find everything I use down below in the description box. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Bye!